Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surbhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 28th of March. Four terrorists neutralized in separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir. US drafts resolution at UN to blacklist Masood Azhar as global terrorist. And Afghanistan says Pakistani Prime Minister comments on its future unacceptable. And now for all the details. Security forces gunned down at least four terrorists in two separate encounters in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province on Thursday. A huge cache of arms and ammunition was also recovered from the possession of the slain terrorists.
At least four terrorists were gunned down by the security forces in two separate encounters in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province on Thursday. Three terrorists belonging to the Hizbul Mujahideen and Lashkar-e-Toyba terror groups were eliminated in Shopian district in a joint operation of Indian Army, Central Reserve Police Force and Jammu and Kashmir Police. A huge cache of arms and ammunition was also recovered from the possession of the terrorists. Meanwhile, in another encounter, one terrorist was neutralized by the security forces in Handwara town of the province. One AK-47 rifle was also recovered from his possession. India accuses neighboring Pakistan of arming and infiltrating terrorists across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley. Pakistan denies the allegations.
Stepping up the international pressure to designate Jaish-e-Mohammed chief Masood Azhar as a global terrorist, the US has moved a draft resolution in the UN Security Council. Azhar's Pakistan-based terror group has claimed responsibility for the deadly suicide attack in February, which killed at least 40 Indian security personnel in India's Jammu and Kashmir.
The United States on Wednesday circulated a draft resolution to the UN Security Council that would blacklist Jaish-e-Mohammed or JEM chief Masood Azhar as a global terrorist, setting up a potential clash with China over the move. This came after China on March 13th blocked India's bid to sanction Masood Azhar at the United Nations. Beijing said it needs more time to evaluate the proposal. Meanwhile, U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Wednesday said on Twitter that on one hand, China abuses more than a million Muslims at home. But on the other hand, it protects violent Islamic terrorist groups from sanctions at the UN. Pompeo was referring to China's move to prevent the blacklisting of Masood Azhar, based in Pakistan, an ally of Beijing. Masood Azhar's group Jaish-e-Mohammed has claimed responsibility for the February 14th attack in India's Jammu and Kashmir that killed at least 40 Indian security personnel and stoked tensions between India and Pakistan. The draft resolution condemns the suicide bombing, reports suggest. If passed, it would subject Masood Azhar to a global travel ban, an assets freeze and an arms embargo.
Moving on, in news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan has strongly criticized Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan's comments on its future, saying the remarks are unacceptable. Khan had on Monday suggested Kabul to set up an interim government in order to have smooth peace talks with the Taliban, which prompted a furious reaction across Afghanistan.
Afghanistan's chief executive Abdullah Abdullah on Wednesday criticized comments made by Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan, who suggested Kabul to set up an interim government in order to have smooth peace talks with the Taliban. The comments made to Pakistani journalists on Monday prompted a furious reaction in Afghanistan and led to the government recalling its ambassador in protest at what it described as irresponsible remarks. Meanwhile, the Pakistani Foreign Ministry has issued a statement saying that Khan's comments, reported in various forms by Pakistani media outlets and picked up in Afghanistan, had been taken out of context and misinterpreted.
اظهاراتی که در مورد افغانستان، سرنوشت افغانستان و تعیین سرنوشت افغانستان از طرف آقای عمران خان صدر اعظم پاکستان صورت گرفته مورد قبول هیچ شهروند کشور نبوده و نیست. تمام مبارزه و قربانی مردم افغانستان برای داشتن حق تعیین سرنوشت بوده.
Relations between Afghanistan and Pakistan have been plagued by mistrust and at times hostility since Pakistan's independence in 1947. Afghanistan has never recognized their common border drawn during British colonial rule through ethnic Pashtun lands.
More news from Afghanistan. Afghanistan's First Lady Rula Ghani has rejected the claims against her of campaigning for election by distributing money to women in Nangarhar province. Rula Ghani said the money that was distributed by her office was only aimed at helping poor women.
Afghanistan's First Lady Rula Ghani on Wednesday rejected any political motives behind money distribution to women in eastern Nangarhar province and said the money that was distributed by her office was only aimed at helping poor women. The remarks by the First Lady came at a time when some footages published on social media recently showed a group of anti-government armed men setting on fire the money which was given as assistance to the women. Rula Ghani has been accused of campaigning for election by distributing money to the women.
Shera mal baitul mal mesozim. Shera shuma sharm nadarim. Shuma rahmat namifamim chikadar khodavand buzurg rahmat ahamiyat meta.
Despite the First Lady rejecting the claims, some members of Nangarhar Provincial Council criticized her overspending the money for electoral campaigns. They said for supporting poor people, there are channels that can do it instead of distribution through her office.
In news from Nepal, India's Foreign Secretary Vijay Gokhale met top Nepali leadership, including Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli, in Kathmandu on Thursday to boost diplomatic ties between the two countries. Gokhale's two-day visit is aimed at reviewing and assessing the past commitments that were made during the visits of Oli to India and two return visits of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Nepal last year. He also called on Nepal's Foreign Minister Pradeep Kumar Gyawali. Earlier in the day, he held talks with his Nepalese counterpart Shankar Das Bairagi. During the meeting, they discussed the substantial progress achieved on bilateral projects and initiatives, including cross-border rail, road and hydroelectric projects. A 10-day-long joint field training exercise among the troops of Indian Army and 16 African nations concluded on Wednesday in India's Western Pune city. The exercise was aimed at acquainting the contingents with each other's operational procedures on humanitarian mine action and peacekeeping operations under United Nations mandate.
A 10-day-long joint field training exercise among the troops of Indian Army and 16 African nations, AFINDEX 2019, concluded on Wednesday in the outskirts of Pune city in India's western Maharashtra province. During the exercise, the soldiers were trained in synchronized operational level planning and tactical level training. They were also trained in establishing military observers in troubled areas and tactically completing a mission without hurting civilians. The exercise was aimed at acquainting the contingents with each other's operational procedures on humanitarian mine action and peacekeeping operations under United Nations mandate.
I recommend that such an exercise be conducted on a regular basis to foster the spirit of friendship, hone military skills, enhance capabilities, and continue to learn from each other.
Soldiers from 16 African nations, including Uganda, South Africa, Sudan, Nigeria, Ghana, Egypt, and many others, participated in the joint military exercise. Apart from 10 soldiers from each participating nation, officers from Rwanda, Democratic Republic of Congo, and Madagascar were involved in the exercise as observer countries.
Tibetans in exile have expressed concern and are struggling to see beyond their spiritual leader, the Dalai Lama, upon his death. They said they fear the decades-long grueling struggle for their homeland will die with their 83-year-old spiritual leader.
Oh.
At a prayer meeting for the health of the Tibetan spiritual leader, Dalai Lama, at his base in northern India, Tibetan refugees said they fear the decades-long grueling struggle for their homeland will die with their 83-year-old spiritual leader. Dalai Lama, who is regarded as one of the most influential people in the world, is a big hope for the 100,000 Tibetans living in exile in India. During the three-day-long special prayers that were held in mid-March for his long life, he blessed hundreds of devotees who met him with great adoration and teary eyes.
If he passed away, then what will the Tibetans do? Because he is the son of our, you know, country. He is the most precious, you know, leader of our country. So we, all the Tibetans are afraid, you know, if he passed away, what may happen? And it is a huge loss to all of us.
Now for us, it's a very sort of, the time is for us a very dangerous time for us today. Because, you know, of course now he has assured us, people like me, I'm still okay because I feel it as long as I live, he is living. So there's no fear. But as you say, for the course of the Tibetan in future, it is the most fear.
The Nobel Peace Laureate, with his following extending beyond Buddhism, has set up a democratic system for Tibetans in exile, but many of them find it difficult to see beyond him. It has been 6 decades since the Tibetan Buddhist leader fled to India after a failed uprising against Chinese rule and has since worked to draw global support for linguistic and cultural autonomy in his remote and mountainous homeland.
An awareness rally was organized on Wednesday in India's northern hill town of Shimla to create awareness among the people about protecting the forest from fires during the summer season. Scores of students passed through busy roads of the town holding placards and raising slogans to sensitize people about benefits of preserving greener wealth.
An awareness rally was organized on Wednesday in India's northern hill town of Shimla to create awareness among the people about protecting the forest from fires during the summer season. More than 300 students from various schools across the hill town participated in the rally and educated the people about their responsibilities and duties to save forest from fires. The student passed through busy roads of the town holding placards and raising slogans to sensitize people about benefits of preserving greener wealth.
सर इसका मकसद ये है कि अगर कभी जंगलों में आग लगती है तो हमें उस चीज के लिए मतलब सर हमें कंप्लेन कर देनी चाहिए उसी वक्त कि भाई वहां पर आग लगी है इस वजह से हमें तभी अच्छी ऑक्सीजन मिल पाएगी हमें हमारा एटमॉस्फेयर साफ रह पाएगा अगर हम ऐसा नहीं करते तो वो हमारे लिए डिसएडवांटेज बन जाएगा एक आगे जाके
मेरा मकसद यह है कि मैं जो ये लोग हैं जो सिगरेट पीते हैं और जो यहाँ वहाँ सिगरेट को बिना बुझाए फेंक देते हैं इससे जो है आग उत्पन्न हो जाती है जंगल जल जाते हैं लोग जनसंख्या बढ़ रही है लोग पेड़ों को काट रहे हैं बट पेड़ों को लगा नहीं रहे हैं
More than 80 awareness camps would be organized as part of the campaign to make people aware about forest fires and develop a mechanism so as to take timely steps to save the forest from being damaged. Besides the awareness campaign, the Provincial Forest Department has also launched new vehicles fitted with water tank to control the fire. A round-the-clock complaint number has also been set up to register complaints of forest fires.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. 4 terrorists neutralized in separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir. US drafts resolution at UN to blacklist Masood Azhar as global terrorist. And Afghanistan says Pakistani Prime Minister's comments on its future unacceptable. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.